is vandaag een dag van vreugde.
Immediately after the end of the Second World War, the Dutch re-established public radio network needed an orchestra capable of making high-quality light music. In fact, much like that played by George Melanchrino's BBC Light Orchestra. Dolf van der Linde was chosen to put such an ensemble together, and he started the project by calling on top-class Dutch musicians who at the time were playing in orchestras across Europe for the Allied forces, and asking them to return to the Netherlands and join this orchestra to be. Van der Linden's bold ideas appealed to a public which was crying out for all sorts of light music, which the occupying forces had denied them for 5 long and dark years. Over the 35 years that he remained at the helm, Dolf van der Linden built the ensemble into an orchestra consisting of a full symphonic string section and a complete big band. But already in the first 10 years of its existence, the ensemble, as of November 1945 under the name Metropole Orkest, became very popular and a household name in the Netherlands, as their broadcasts could be heard some 4 to 5 times a week in millions of living rooms across the country. And each time, the Metropole opened the program with its signature tune, composed by Dolf himself, Park Lane Serenade. Metropole's very first broadcast took place on the 25th of November 1945. Dolf van der Linde directed his 37-piece orchestra during a 30-minute program. Unfortunately, there is no trace of this first broadcast, but right now you can listen to the Gypsy Song, recorded just after that November broadcast.
And look in the future and drive away all your fears. Everything will come right if you only believe that
during the year 1946, Dolf van der Linde and his Metropole Orkest fulfilled an additional objective of the new public radio network, namely playing songs that offered optimistic views of a bright and sunny future that was looming in the not-too-distant future. Here is an example of such a song with vocalist Nettie van Doorn, who as Nettie Rosenfeld was to become a well-known radio program announcer. The song's title? Well, in English it would be something like, sometime not too long from now, Holland will be blossoming again.
Dat Nederlands glorie nooit ten onder gaat. Eens zal de Betuwe in bloei weer staan en groeit op wolven hout heel graag.
In the remainder of the section covering the Metropole Orkest's first 10 years, you can now listen to music that is characteristic for that period. Many tunes are composed or arranged by the maestro Dolph van der Linden and have appeared on gramophone records, mostly 78s, on labels such as Paxton, Philips and Decca. The music in this section appears according to the year in which they have been recorded, starting with the year 1952.